begin this evening by acknowledging the land on which we are today. This is the traditional territory of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee, and the Neutral Peoples. We do this to reaffirm our commitment and responsibility in improving relationships between nations and improving our own understanding of Indigenous peoples, their cultures, and their historic connections to place. The people living on this land for thousands and thousands of years represent many and varied cultures, systems of governments, and languages, as well as unique musical traditions. We see these musical traditions today being practiced in their historical context, as well as in the modern context of cultural expression, activism, and identity. This evening's concert is one of many celebrations throughout this year, marking the 60th anniversary of Conrad Grebel University College. Tonight's is a musical celebration, and I think that's why you're all here, you know that already. There are many ways in which that is being represented by the music that's being performed tonight. First of all, there are three compositions that have been specially composed, two for tonight, which will be heard for the very first time, and one for the 50th anniversary, 10 years ago, of the college. And they are on the program this evening, about which you'll hear a little more in a little while. We also are welcoming back a long-term faculty member of the department, Catherine Robertson, as our accompanist this evening. Catherine was a piano studio instructor for more than 20 years, director of the chapel choir, taught piano literature, among many other things. Catherine retired from the department in 2019, just in time for, you know, what happened. And Catherine, it's wonderful to welcome you back in this concert this evening. We will also this evening hear from two alumni composers, Julia Jacklein and Candace Bustard, and I will invite them up here a little bit later in the program, just before we perform their pieces, to hear a little bit about their where their lives have gone since being at Grebel, and a little bit about the compositions you're going to hear. Those pieces, and also the 50th anniversary piece with which we will close tonight's concert, Psalm 150 by Tim Corliss, were supported through the Henry A. and Ann Schultz Memorial Fund. Just want to take a moment to acknowledge that and to thank that family for the sponsorship, the foundation that allows for us to commission new music from composers. And we have, I think, two members of that family with us this evening, Nancy Riviere and Janet Sack. So welcome here, and we're glad you're part of tonight's concert. Without any further ado, we now turn our attention to the back of the church in the loft. We will hear from the chapel choir and the chamber choir for our first three selections, beginning with Before the Marvel of This Night, conducted by Professor Kate Stucker. Thanks for being here this evening, and enjoy the concert.
Thank you. and yet so wildly uncontrollable.
Thank you. enjoy an afternoon reading books, to walk in the sunlight of the rain.
Thank you. anyway, whatever it is, don't be afraid of its plenty. Joy is not made to be a crumb.
Fly, Demi-lark, fly ever so tenderly, fly ever so slowly, taking the beauty of the earth below. Cherish your memories of trips past, but cherish too all in your past now. Cherish.
The tree branches at night, backlit by lights, the droplets caught in leaves as they sparkle in the sunlight, the gentle movement of wind in leaves, the vastness of the night sky. Those acts of kindness between people who seek nothing.
And you, what might you cherish?
Thank you.
cherish. Am I good enough?
There's just so much to do. I don't even know where to start.
Thank you.
two alumni of our music program, Julia Jacklein and Candace Bustard, composers of the next two pieces on tonight's program. Welcome back. As I mentioned earlier in the evening, these two pieces are part of the 60th anniversary celebrations of the college, and we thought as a music department it would be a great idea to look back into our past history in the department and ask two composers to write us pieces. And so, as we faculty huddle around, who would these two composers be? These two names quickly came to the surface, and we thought this would be a really great idea. So, what I thought we could do is hear a little bit about the piece, but before even that, hear a little bit about what both Julia and Candace have been up to since they left here. So, I've heard a couple of questions. They know what they are already, and we'll begin maybe with Julia asking if you have a particular memory of a Grebel course or a music department event or something in your memory bank that has stayed with you all these years.
Hi, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here and a real honor. Thank you. Yeah, so from my time at Grebel in the early 2000s, what really sticks out is my enjoyment of the choirs that I participated in, the chapel choir and the chamber choir, and also one time when they ran through a piece of mine, which was lovely back then, just to have that experience. Yeah, so that sticks out for me.
Wonderful. And I pose the same question to you, Candace.
Living in the city, I
got together and conceived this idea. She wrote the lyrics, and I like sat at the piano trying to set them to music. And the result is this piece that is about three verses, and each verse comes closer and closer to this idea of unity. And I achieved this through a few different techniques. So one of them is with each, I call them movements, they're not movements, with each verse, the different vocal parts have very individualistic melodies, right? So everything has like their own rhythm, everything has their own melody, and then gradually those ideas converge towards the end into like a moment of unity and joy. And then I also included these bell tolls, and historically bells have been used as a call to join in this community. So you can hear those as well throughout the piece.
With my piece, when I was looking for a text, the text by Bjørnson stuck out for me, just because it combines, it brings together so many things that I felt that Grebel stands for. Community, meeting through music, conflict resolution. And I chose to set that text to music. And actually, the way it came together was just, it was very natural. I didn't think too much about it. I just thought back to my time at Grebel. I thought about the poem, and the music came. So yeah.
They are both very beautiful pieces, very different pieces, and we have enjoyed learning them. It's always an honor and a challenge to be the first.